That ain't God's peace. You can have a house and a woman in an organ all the time. functional in a dysfunctional ability. Mm. They have learned to be functional in a dysfunctional ability. They were believing a lie. They were coming and going. Coming and going. And that just says nothing happened. Dysfunctionality, that's what I'm trying to say. They learn how to be comfortable and they adapt to the sickness and the pain. That sounds like us right there. Mm-hmm. because half of us are late doing what we do, but God can save you. Y'all better pick up the bed. Man, the man laid down, and then he got up, and he started walking, and everybody saw him. I said, ooh, Lord, have mercy. Picture this. You'll never have to lay in that place again. You'll never have to beg anybody to help you. Because he can do what? He walk, he take care of himself. He can get a job. If any man be in Christ, he's a new creator. His life changed tremendously. You understand? It changed tremendously. Y'all ever read the story? You ever look at the story and imagine and picture what was going on? You ever read the story of the prodigal son? It's about a man that had two sons. We only think about one. But read the end of the story. It's about two sons. You understand? But then again, it ain't probably no one. It's just a man that had two sons. And what I discovered was there may not have been no woman in the picture. He may have been a second daddy because a woman is not mentioned. That's in the theater of your life. Picture this, y'all. Picture your situation right now. I'm going to sit down and say to yourself, am I really, really a child of God? Do I really do what children of God do? Even if I can help somebody. If I can help somebody. Amen. And guess what? You don't have to help them by giving them $1 million. You don't have to help them by giving them $1. Because I go to Kroger sometimes, and that's my wife. I do it all the time. I get a truckload of problems and just give it away. You should see the faces of the people. Well, they say, me, I don't have to pay nothing. You don't have to pay nothing. It's free. It's free. And you don't have to pay nothing for your healing and getting saved. We need saved people in this church. You need to pick up your bed and you need to walk. It's an action word. You walk. Walk. I'm going to walk into my blessing. Because I know what God did for me. I don't know about nobody else. Don't testify for me now. Be your own witness. You understand? I've been at this for 37 years. 37 years I've been at this. You understand? And if I don't understand the word now, I'll never, ever understand it. Anybody want to pray? Come on, let's pray. Come on, come on. Let's pray and ask God. That is to help us walk. I want to walk into my blessing. Walk into your blessing. Walk into your blessing and don't let anything hinder you. A dollar will never hinder me from getting in the heaven. I ain't like some folks. I ain't like him. You understand? I see some people, they like the fox. They can't eat the corn, but they don't want nobody else to have nothing. I'm not like that. But I guarantee you, if you would come right now and just say this, Lord, I want to walk. That's what I want to do. I want to walk and understand. Spiritually, physically, pick up your bed. Pick up your bed. You've been in the pool or at the pool, but that stays your home. You've been around all of that stench and sickness and everything. You keep going back. When are you going to get rid of a fabric? And I ain't talking about the what? I named the fire because I knew the situation here. You understand? God has been good to all of us. And we're going to pray that the Lord will bless us. Father, you are the healer and the deliverer. I don't know nobody else that can just heal on the spot like you can. Nobody else. A man that was impotent for almost 4 decades. And guess what you did? You came home and you said, pick up your bed and walk. We want to walk today, God. We want to be blessed by your power divine, your healing power, virtue, and all of those healing virtue and all of those great things. But most of all, Lord, we look at a man that wasn't saved. Amen. But Jesus is always good at saying, you understand you may go, but your sins are also forgiven. So along with this infirmity, along with this thing, Lord, that's holding us Jesus.